story. We've added a few things to make it opera, but mostly it's a true story. Everyone involved with this project is a volunteer. They are passionate about this project. They've donated huge commitments of time, coaching, evenings away from family, other performance opportunities missed. A lot of people have done a lot to make this happen. So I'd like to thank all the cast and the performers, because everyone has given so much of themselves. I have a couple other things that I'd like to also do. El Pueblo de Los Angeles Historical Monument has authorized this production. They are the governing, the city governing body over Olvera Street, allow us to use the name and the story. The South Pasadena Women's Club, who has been a great benefactor and supporter of our operas over the years. A couple people I have to mention: Lonnie Bartlett, our associate producer; Sean Taylor, our stage director; Randy Garrou, our chorus master; Frank DeSeal, associate conductor; Wendy Knittle, accompanist; Jeff Richards, Paul Young, Sean Hughes, Dan Duchesne, and Donald Clinton for tirelessly setting up and breaking down sets, building props, doing everything we need. And also thanks to our composer, L.C. Harnsberger, and librettist, Robert Cartland. Before we proceed with Olvera Street, everyone is aware that the tragedy that happened in Paris, and so our composer stayed up last night and made an arrangement of Marseillaise, so we will do that now.
Treat the greatest chef in Los Angeles?
The greatest chef, the greatest drunk.
Come on, Gino. Just one more drink.
The sun's coming up. The party's over.
Please, Church? Will there be wine?
Of
Lucia.
How can this be? I don't know anyone who supplies this pharmaceutical.
It's those eggs in the suburbs. They don't know from nothing.
What about my Duffy?
Let's go to church. It'll make you feel better.
Some of the locals might disagree with the location of Union Station.
They
our wine to the church.
Sure. What about that girl of yours who runs the cafe?
Lucia?
Rumor is she won't tighten up because you run the speak easy.
That's none of your business.
The chief is only suggesting that this is an opportunity for you to explore new ventures.
Adventures?
Ventures. A change in career.
Well, if I had to go, I would marry Lucia and move to Hollywood and become the next rule on that one.
Well, you should receive a sizable sum, dear winery owner. Eminent domain.
Eminent what?
Eminent domain.
It means when they take over your winery to give the station, you get a check.
They're going to give me money.
You'll be fairly compensated. That's the law.
No, no, no. Making wine for 100 years.
Just think of what you could do with the dough.
Eminent domain, eminent domain, eminent by your Hollywood, eminent every time, make your reach come
history, the birthplace of the significant. like Chicago and New York. The boys that level the whole place, the plaza, Olvera Street, is wonderful. I can dump the speakeasy, and we can finally be married.
Reminds me of what the Lord teaches.
Thank you.
lonely nest and survived many storms.
It reminds me of my little pueblo where I was born. We left because of the war. I was only a child, but I wanted to stay and fight.
I bet you did.
But my parents refused. Now, I may have to leave Olvera Street and find a new home again.
Or fight.
In a way, it is not easy.
Just like the life of a swallow.
Sí, como la vida de una golondrina.
Thank you. It is Mexican. Please
Peter, would you please entertain your sister?
Thank you.
Families, their lives, business, Yeah. the beach. You cannot stop them. You're just a poor Mexican woman with a tiny cafe and a crazy Anglo friend.
I wish I could make you understand.
I do. You love your cafe more than me.
That's no fair.
Don't worry. Soon I'll get my money for my winery, and you'll never see me again.
Do you really think they care about us?
Mrs. Sterling, please allow me to help. All I want is some food.
And a drink or two?
No, no, no. I'm dry. I haven't touched a drop in 2 months.
Good job, sir.
Well, the food is free, but we kindly take your donation of labor. Won't we, Lucia?
Thank you, Miss Lucia. Today, I'm going to prepare the finest chiles en nogada you ever tasted. For an ordinary chef, perhaps, but I was the greatest chef in Los Angeles. My family's prepared this dish since Emperor Augustine visited La Puebla. Today, the colors of the Mexican flag will wave on our food. Don't worry.
A chef is like an architect. Instead of lines on a paper, I design with a recipe. Many write theirs down, but I keep mine in my head. A chef is like a chemist. Instead of a periodic table, I use a well-stocked pantry. Cooking starch, salt, and spice need to be combined just right. A chef thinks like a builder. A knife is my saw, and my foundation starts in a mixing bowl. Water stated to exceed into planks and nails. A chef measures twice and just cuts once. He measures twice and just cuts once. Just once. Just once.
Thank you.
raise a glass to Christine Sterling.
Drink, sir?
No, thank you.
But it's a toast to Mrs. Sterling.
A toast? Well, all right. One tiny drink. Muy piquet.
To Christine Sterling, who restored the dignity of the grand Spanish honors, who once called this adobe home. She will transform the rest of Olvera Street into a place of pride for the citizens of Los Angeles.
Thank you, my dear friend.
The Signor Chandler. Al Padrino, muchas gracias.
Vengo.
down. There is a respectable party going on here. My apologies. This is Sterling. And you too. This is an outrage. An outrage!
Reginald!
Thank you. part of the merchants, Olvera Street will be closed. Preserving the history of Los Angeles is more important than your businesses.
What? You close our shops, put people out of work.
Throw in some lies.
You freeze out our families.
This needs to stop.
This needs to stop.
This needs to stop.
Much of our work is closed.
My cousin is a lawyer.
This needs to stop. For this only we have to.
Yet.
can do.
One tiny drink, boy, big hand.
It's everywhere, the money's everywhere. Gino,
That's right.